Did you know that Apple Silicon Macs run two operating systems in order to function? And this second, secretive OS, is the primary reason why you can't upgrade an SSD in an Apple Silicon Mac. And that's not even the full story. Apple Silicon Macs and T2-equipped Intel Macs, iPhones, iPads, and even the Apple Watch use a dedicated hardware component known as the Secure Enclave. And it's more than just marketing. The Secure Enclave is a separate processor designed specifically to handle the sensitive operations related to security and privacy on your Mac or other device. One of the main operations for the Secure Enclave is to generate and store encryption keys and biometric data like Touch ID, and it needs to protect this from various attacks like physical tampering and side channel attacks. In order to do this, it needs its own memory and storage, and it needs to be isolated from the rest of the system. And to do all of that, it needs its own stripped-down operating system. Known as Secure Enclave OS or Secure Enclave Processor OS, hence sepOS. The Secure Enclave can only be accessed by the rest of the hardware through a few protected APIs. When a user sets up a password on an Apple Silicon Mac, the password is passed through a one-way hashing algorithm that produces a key that is used to encrypt the Secure Enclave's key. To break this down, this means that even if someone has a user's password, they cannot access the encryption keys stored on the Secure Enclave without the Secure Enclave's cooperation. This is pretty important. This means that the encrypted data must pass through the Secure Enclave, the operating system, and the user never get to see this encryption key and can only interact with the Secure Enclave through APIs. The Secure Enclave also uses a unique identifier, a root cryptographic key called the Secure Enclave ID, which is used to identify the device. This is fused to the Secure Enclave during manufacturing and without Apple's ability to access it. This ensures that the encryption keys stored in the Secure Enclave can only be used on the device that they were generated on. Yes, I know this is getting complicated, but say you stole the physical NAND memory modules out of a MacBook Pro, and you even had the encryption keys. This theoretical attack wouldn't work because the hardware encryption key doesn't match the hardware ID. The Secure Enclave also helps thwart DMA attacks, where an attacker uses a device with direct memory access, like a Thunderbolt device. A Thunderbolt device uses a PCIe interconnect, and one of the main selling points of PCIe is direct memory access. macOS encrypts its memory and uses an I/O processor that manages communication between the main processor and the Secure Enclave. The memory needs to be encrypted and decrypted, and any device trying to attack the memory will just get encrypted data. Apple refers to this as the memory protection engine. I want to be clear that this is not unique to macOS, as there are both Windows and Linux analogs. Also, AMD and Intel have introduced their own hardware-level protections. Handling all of this is sepOS. sepOS is designed to be resistant to attacks, including physical tampering, and it has been certified under the Common Criteria Security Standard. The OS is based on the L4 microkernel, which is popular for secure embedded systems as it has a minimal set of services and uses a highly privileged mode that is isolated from the user-level code. I know, this is starting to get pretty abstract, but the point is there's a well-defined interface and the kernel is small and focused. Thus, it is easy to analyze and verify by security analysts and has a design that allows for specialized isolated subsystems. Apple has taken this micro operating system and modified it for use in the Secure Enclave. The Secure Enclave also provides other services like True Random Number Generation, Secure Neural Engine, an AES engine, Secure Enclave Boot ROM, a Secure Enclave Boot Monitor, and so on. If you would like to learn more about this and the Secure Enclave, I suggest reading the Apple document on it, as it's what I used to make this video. And of course, it's linked in the description. Now, if you remember back to the beginning of this video, I mentioned that the Secure Enclave is the reason why you can't upgrade your SSD. SSDs generally consist of a controller, NAND memory modules, DRAM cache found on quality SSDs, and an interface like NVMe. Apple's Secure Enclave is tightly integrated for Apple hardware, and the SSD controller resides within the Apple Silicon chipset. As we previously discussed, the Secure Enclave generates a hardware encryption key and is used to encrypt the contents of the NAND memory modules, or the storage. The key is stored in the Secure Enclave, and the keys are derived from a combination of the Secure Enclave ID and the characteristics of the NAND. Now, I have to be clear, the next part is a bit of conjecture on my part, because the Mac Studio, you can swap the NANDs, but only with ones that are exactly the same size. This also requires a DFU restore. So let's get back to it. If a set of new NAND modules were installed onto an Apple Silicon Mac, it would have to generate a new key. A hypothetical attacker might be able to determine the original key by comparing the old key and the new key and identifying the differences between the two. This potentially could reveal characteristics about the original key. Apple allowing any NANDs to be swapped could potentially be used as a way to compromise the system. While Apple uses PCIe for its interface to its NANDs, it does not use the NVMe protocol. Also, the SSD controller has direct communication to the Secure Enclave. Now, here's the kicker. I'm absolutely confident that Apple could arrive at a solution, as Apple's Secure Enclave has gone through many iterations. 16, in fact, as of recording this video. I am not a system security engineer, but I have my suspicions. Apple could arrive at a solution that allows users to swap SSDs by reducing the security settings or perhaps an unlock that warns the user about the potential of encryption key exposure. And there are unified memory systems that use NVMe and even hardware encryption, so this is not insurmountable. I consider myself an informed user, and I'd gladly accept any risk for removable storage over being locked into zero upgrades, as NAND memory, which makes up the SSD, has a finite shelf life. A memory cell on an SSD can only be written and overwritten so many times before it fails. Apple preventing anyone from swapping SSDs means that every Apple Silicon Mac has a time bomb built into it, and there's nothing end users can do to fix it. Despite the greenwash marketing, Apple has no qualms about e-waste. Also, to pour salt in the wound, Apple shipping bottom-tier Macs and RAM-starved configurations with laughably small SSDs means that the OS will have no choice but to use the SSD for memory swap operations when the RAM is completely filled. And the more frequently it does this, and with fewer bytes to rotate on a small SSD like a 256GB, will shorten the NAND shelf life. Apple chooses not to tackle this on any front, as it knows it'll generate money, no matter how this plays out. A user has to pay upfront Apple tax on overpriced upgrades and has to deal with planned obsolescence baked into the hardware and software. Let's not forget, Apple will stop supporting its Macs at some point. Admittedly, the security is amazing, but Apple should not be able to hide behind security as a smokescreen for its anti-consumer behavior. So when you see right to repair legislation pop up, please support it. Apple makes wonderful products, but they're marred by their disdain for the users that buy them. This video was tough to make because there's not a lot of information about sepOS or the Secure Enclave. So if you have any corrections or better resources, hit me in the comments and check the description for the sources I used. Thanks for watching.